हेलो गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टेल अबाउट ए न्यू सीरीज। सो आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अबाउट यूनिक्स प्रोग्रामिंग। इन पास आई स्टार्टेड ए सीरीज अबाउट पाइथन एंड आई एक्सप्लेन्ड अबाउट अप टू पाइथन स्कैपी मॉड्यूल एंड आई लेफ्ट ओवर द वीडियोज अपलोडिंग एंड एंड इफ आई फाउंड एनी न्यू वीडियो आई मीन इफ आई फाउंड एनी न्यू मॉड्यूल्स एक्सप्लेनेशन देन आई विल अपलोड इट to Python playlist that is in our channel. Okay, that is I mean I stopped doing videos about Python. If I found any new things about Python that we can do, I will upload videos frequently. But now I am going to start with Linux programming series, and this is the and these are the topics that we are going to cover in this Unix programming series. So first one is Unix commands. So there are basic commands like what you can say, like basic commands like chmod, pwd, ls, process states, and like this. These are the basic commands that we are going to cover in the first part. And here awk and sed, as these are the two utilities that are used to project your output to the screen by using some regular expressions, which are going to be covered in the first part. So that you need to see the videos in a particular order from first to last, so that then only you can understand the videos and the concepts perfectly. And at here we are going to deal with the shell programming, meta characters, command substitutions, and how the shell will take input, how we need to print the output, and about the grouping commands. And at last we are going to deal with the system calls known as file system, and these system calls are divided into so many categories. One is network system calls, like we can you know that we can create a reverse I mean sorry we can deal with sockets and sockets, and we can create an file sorry we can create a reverse shell using these system calls. So these are the system calls, and we are going to deal with our file system calls like read, open, write, lseek, fseek, like that. Those are the file system calls that we are going to discuss about the those are the file system calls that we are going to deal in this series. And it after that we are going to deal with the child process and the parent process. Means these fork system call and exec family and nice system call. And fork system call is used to duplicate the process, and exec system call is used to execute the each thread or process, and nice system call is used to change the priority of the process. So like this, these are the system calls that we are going to deal in this Unix programming. See here if there are any topics that I had mentioned in this in this PPT, if I had left over any topics that I mentioned, I will cover in the videos. Don't bother about that. And I am going to do some videos about how to create a reverse shell using Unix programming and something like that, so that we are going to complete this Unix series like by learning about these topics. And if any new topics that I had found, I will automatically add into our new Unix programming series, so that you can update, so that you can get updates from my side. And if you want to know about Unix programming more, you can contact me on Discord server. The Discord server link is in the description of this video. And if you are interested in doing assembly language, I mean in learning assembly language, you can see the And you can view my playlist that I am going to left in the cards or at the end of the videos, so that you can go through with that also. Whereas an x86 assembly language is very very useful in order to program with program to a microprocessor like that. So if you have if you ever seen the header files like UINIST dot h, or something like that. If we ever view that header files, it consists of some system calls like write system call, open system call, read system call, and particularly it will be assigned with a number called 421 or like that. All this explanation I covered in x86 assembly videos. You can go through my playlist that I am going to left over in my cards, or in the video description you can go through the x86 assembly videos also. So before you are going to start with Unix programming, you must install any Unix operating system like Kali Linux or Ubuntu like that. You can use any of the operating system like you can use VirtualBox or any VMware like that, VMware softwares like that. You can use any of those with a particular configuration so that you can start learning Unix programming. So that is what all I got for this video. If you did hit the like button, it will help me to do more videos, and I will get motivated. Please do subscribe to our channel. Have a great day.